If you want to find out the final result of the Pan That Palette for 2022, then stick around. Hi there, it's Elaine, and welcome back, or if it's your first time, welcome to HMM Makeup, or Makeup. I wanted to come on here and do a short video, and that is to officially declare the Pan That Palette for HMM Makeup for 2022. And if you have been following my community tab, I will put a link in the description box if you're not familiar with what a community tab is, so that you can click on it and discover that for YouTube channels in general going forward. So it'll be the link to my personal community tab for this channel, but if you are not familiar with community tabs, you may enjoy that discovery to follow what a creator wants to communicate to you without necessarily doing a video. So I have put these results on the community tab, but I realize not everybody goes there, so I wanted to film a video, and you may hear from my voice that I have been recovering from some difficulties health-wise, and it took me a while to film this video, and so my apologies for the delay, but I wanted to make sure to film a video for the folks who don't necessarily go off the video path toward the other resources that a YouTuber might have. So what I want to do is cover the five palettes that were being rated basically by the community here at HMM Makeup, and give you from least points to most points which palette made it and why. And there are a couple of interesting stats here as I go along that I've noticed, and I just want to share some of those insights for you. So the palette that was the least voted for is the Sigma Rendezvous palette, or Rendezvous, if you will. This is the one. So this one received a voting from 10 people and received a total of 22 points. So it made this palette fifth place holder. And let me just show you the palette. All of these palettes are beautiful, so that it's more of a warm tone palette. And it's quite pretty. I do really like it. It was a gift from Jen Loves Reviews, and I was very grateful for it. It came with a blush and a highlighter duo as well, and it's a beautiful palette. I do quite enjoy the shimmers, and almost put this palette on my eyes today, actually, for this video, but it changed my mind last second. So this is fifth place, and like I said, I think it was 10 people voted for it for 1, 2, 3, 2, up to 6 points. So 6 points was the total available to anyone to vote. Now in fourth place is the palette that is actually on my inner two-thirds of the lid. It's a beautiful, beautiful palette, just like the Sigma Rendezvous palette is. 11 people voted for this one, and it collected a total of 27 points, and it's the Ciate Glitter Storm. I think it's a gorgeous palette. The packaging is gorgeous, as is the inside. And I will show you which one I put on my eyes in case you have this palette and you wanted to know. And yeah, it's this one. This is the shadow that I have on the inner to two-thirds of the lid, and it is called Pandora. And I really think it's gorgeous. It's hard. With these three, it's hard not to feel like an absolute babe ready to go to a gala in using this palette. So it's quite pretty. So this one, like I said, fourth place, 11 people voted for it. Okay, so that was we've covered the fifth place and the fourth place. Now we're going to go to the third place. The next one I want to talk about is also a Ciate palette, and it is the Ciate Morello 2. And this palette received votes from 11 people and got a total of 36 points. So it's definitely in third place, and it's It's one of my absolute favorites in my collection, to be quite frank, and I will end up panning this one no matter what. I do love the amount of mattes in this palette, and that second row and bottom row are really what have my heart. I feel like the top row and the third row are kind of utilitarian, but overall it's all very much usable. And it doesn't feel intimidating. It's not a huge size, but it feels perfect. So this one, again, made third place. I kind of wanted this one to win, but you have spoken, and we'll see what happens next year. All right, so now let's go into what ended up in second place. In second place, and I completely believe this because of how gorgeous this palette is, it received a total of 18 people voting for it and garnered a whole 38 points. The Becca Volcano Goddess, it's a beautiful palette. The outside is gorgeous. I may repurpose this packaging once it's empty. And this is what the palette looks like. It is beautiful. A lot of very usable shadows here, and then some very nice pops of color in one column there. And also the outside matches the inside, which I always appreciate in a palette. It is a very sophisticated looking palette. I would not have been sad in working with this palette for the year for sure. I will just say, you have good taste, folks. Was very pleased to see this one show up in second place because it does have a lot of attributes that I appreciate in an eyeshadow palette. And finally, the palette that did win by 1 point. The Volcano Goddess was 38 points total. This one made it to 39 points, just 1 point more. 15 people voted for it, but it consistently got high point values per person, which is why it ended up higher up, despite the fact that fewer people voted for it than Volcano Goddess, so go figure. So a total of 39 points, as I mentioned, 15 people, the Volcano Goddess 38 points, and 18 people, I think, yeah. So this one won it, and I'm quite excited about it because it's a cool tone palette, which I had introduced when I introduced all the palettes before, with a great big highlighter here that is beautiful. And I have done a couple of looks already. I've used this one, I've used these two, and this one for a look, and it's a fun palette to use. I did get a request from one of my subscribers, Salut Julie, to do a bit of a lookbook with this palette. And given it is the Pan That palette for 2022, I don't mind doing that. So you can expect to see a lookbook with this palette. And I think I can do quite a few. I can do a couple of monochromatic looks using these guys right here. I can also do monochromatic look kind of with this area, and then really glam it up with a couple of shadows as well. So at least three looks should be pretty easy. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, I could see four looks easily without really doing all that much head scratching. So if you are interested in seeing that, you can expect to see that on this channel. In a while, I will take time to photograph each one of the looks and give you a lookbook when I am ready to do so. All in all, I really appreciate folks voting either under the intro video or on the community tab on the website associated with the YouTube channel. Thank you so much to everyone who participated. I would not have been able to do this tally and this ranking without you. So thank you so much for your participation. And I do look forward to reporting back on how I'm doing with that MAC palette. And that is it from me. Thank you so much once again. I appreciate it every single time you offer feedback and your votes and your engagement. And of course, I appreciate you watching this video today. And with that, I will close the video. Thank you again, and see you in the next one. But for now, take care.